This is the ETBU Sports Den of NP Ledger here with head football coach Scotty Walden. Coach, coming off a 60-47 win over Belhaven University, start 4-0. Just talk about the win over Belhaven in Mississippi.
Yeah, a lot of fun getting that win because it was a tough, hard-fought victory off the bye week. You know, when you go on the road and play anybody in the ASC, you know, it's going to be a challenge. And they got a, you know, that new stadium they got over there and the setup and everything. I mean, it was definitely a fun atmosphere for our guys to play in, and but it was tough as well. So really proud of our guys just showing the fight and resiliency on the road. They started making a push there, and they kept that game within two scores the whole time, and it was really hard fought battle, but you know our guys found a way to win, and that's what I love about this team is they're unbelievably resilient and their fight, you know, and determination to win. They expect to win, and they're going to do everything they can to win, whether it's by offense, defense, special teams. You know, they found a way to win that game, and that was awesome to see.
Talk about offense first and how they kind of came out, set the tone in the first quarter, and always kept a two-score lead and scored when they needed to, especially in the fourth quarter, to go up 21 points. Before they came back and scored right there before the end of the game.
Yeah, really proud of our execution offensively. I think, I thought Drew led our offense, did a great job with execution, and thought the group I'm most proud of, though, is our offensive line, without question. Those guys, we got a little banged up a few times, and then we had some guys missing some playing time, and it was just next man up. And that was awesome to see our guys step up, and we didn't miss a beat. You know, we threw in a true freshman center for a little bit, and he got in there, mixed it up, did a great job. We rotated some guys up there, and we didn't miss a beat. I thought we were able to run the football vertically, and that's where our offense starts, is being able to run the football. And so our O-line played great. I obviously don't like the one turnover and also the ball being on the ground, but you know those things have been addressed, and our guys know that, you know, we won't have zero turnovers a game. But really impressed with the way our guys performed. We needed to snap it 80 plus times. We snapped it 95 times, and that was imperative for this game for us to keep our defense fresh. And so I love the way we moved the ball. I love the tempo in which we played with. I thought we really pushed the pace on those guys, and it was able to help us score some points.
The defense also did well as they had a goal line stand and a couple fourth down conversions where they turn the ball over and downs back to ETBU's offense. Just talk about how the defense did.
Yeah, I was really proud of our defense. I mean, you know, I think our guys understand our standard, and our standard is not to give up 47 points, and they know that. But at the same time, our defense did a fantastic job. So proud of the way those guys play, because, you know, you're defending an offense that is one of the best offenses we'll see with their aerial attack. You know, it's one of the best in the country. I think that quarterback is the real deal, like we talked about. He's a really good player, and their wide receivers are really impressive as well. And our guys having to defend 99 snaps, and you know about 70 of those were passes. You know that is a lot of running for our defensive backs and our D line to get pass rush, and they just stayed with it. They never, if they got scored on, they never had their head down. They just kept plugging away, and it led to us getting a big time stop down there on the goal line. Led to some huge four down stops. You know, with the way those guys play, they can fake it any time on you on fourth down, and we were able to stop all fakes and not allow an extra possession. So our defense found a way. They found a way to win the game. So I was proud of the physicality they played with as well, and able to get some key stops at key moments for us to win that game.
Special teams was also a big factor. Forced a fumble on a kickoff. That was a momentum changer there. And then Ryan Travis also kicked a big field goal there in the game. So talk about how the special teams did.
Yeah, really proud of our special teams unit. You know, I thought Southwestern, I thought we took a few steps back in a few of our units. I thought we could have played a lot better. Got some things corrected on the bye week. Guys did a fantastic job executing on special teams, starting with Ryan Travis averaging 40 yards a punt, in addition to hitting the key field goal. And then his kickoffs, you know, hung up there for such a long time to allow our posse unit or our kickoff unit get down there and make some plays. Proud of the demeanor. You know, that was the biggest thing in spring and in fall camp, is to try to change that kickoff unit's mentality to a go-get-it mentality and go-make-a-play mentality. And Ty Parsons and DeLonzo Freeman, they stuck out, you know, when you watch the film, with giving max effort, and Ty forced the fumble, and then DeLonzo was able to recover it. Just guys giving phenomenal effort. You know, Austin Odell runs down there with his hair on fire and makes plays on kickoff as well. And so really, really satisfied, really impressed with our special teams, and we just want to keep that going.
With that, Drew Smith was just named the ASC Offensive Player of the Week. He had six touchdowns overall in the day, four passing and two rushing. Just talk about the first offensive award for ETBU this year.
Yeah, really proud to get on that. You know, that's our second award overall, with Zach Biles being named defensive player of the week one. And with Drew, you know, you just talk about a guy who's just ultra competitive. You know, he brings it every day, and he's a guy that on game day, that I don't know if there's many guys that want to win as bad as that guy does. An upperclassman, a guy that has bounced around a few schools and found his home here at ETBU, and that's just awesome to see. Awesome story from Drew, but just really, really excited and pumped for him. You know, he came out and executed the game plan. He you know, followed through with his focus points we had for him for the week, and had a great 2 weeks of practice. I think he completed nearly 80% of his footballs in practice over the last 2 weeks, and so that led to a great game. You know, I think you'll play how you practice, and he's the guy that brings it every day in the film room, a guy that brings it every day on the practice field, and so we continue to expect him to continue to lead our guys and be a big contributor for us, but really pleased with this play and excited for him.
Looking at national rankings, fifth week in a row, ETBU has been ranked, continues to be a program record. State 17th in D3 football, 18th in AFCA. Just talk about continuously being nationally ranked.
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, like we talked about last week, you know, we want to be in the spotlight. We want to be in those top 25 rankings, and our guys want to be there, and we're not going to shy away from that. You know, it's an exciting time, you know, for the Tigers, man. It's an exciting time for our program, and we're just trying to build on it each week. You know, we don't focus or talk too much about it, but at the same time, you know, our guys, you know, we want to be nationally recognized and for the hard work we're putting in and for the success we're having, and our guys deserve it. You know, our kids compete. They bring it every day in practice. You know, you ask any of our kids about Tuesday, Wednesday practice, you know, they hate it because it's tough. You know, it's hard, but they know that they have to earn the right to win the game on Saturday, and that's what they're doing. And I'm just so proud of their effort on and off the field, and their efforts during the week in practice, and the hard work pays off. That's what we talk about, and we just want to keep that thing rolling.
This weekend you head back on the road again, second week in a row you travel, this time going west to West Texas, travel to McMurry University in Abilene. Talk about the team that you'll see in playing them there in Abilene.
Yeah, McMurry. I tell you what, the competition doesn't waver at all in the ASC. Week to week, you're gonna get some really good football teams, and McMurry. You know, watching them on tape and seeing what they bring to the table. I think they've got a quarterback who, while he's young, man, you don't know what you're gonna get with that kid, man. He is a phenomenal playmaker. He scrambles around. He finds a way to make plays. I think they got a great receiving core. Number 21, I think, is a really good receiver for them, and they have some playmakers that can do some big time things. Defensively. I think the defense is the strength of their team. You know, I think they return a lot of guys defensively. Their secondary might be the best one we've seen, in all honesty, with those guys being junior, senior led. I think those guys do a great job on the back end. The front seven is strong as well. So, you know, going on the road for the second week in a row, that's a big challenge for our kids. And anytime you go on the road to try to win a college football game, it's a challenge, and especially when you're playing somebody for their homecoming. And so, you know, it's going to be a big atmosphere there in Abilene, and we'll have to go in there, and we're have to be conquerors, you know, and go in there and conquer all obstacles that are in our way and find a way to get a big win on the road. And I told our guys too yesterday at our team meeting, you know, it counts for real now. These ASC games count for real, and so we're 0-0, and you know, we're not focused on anything in the past. We're just focused on this week and focused with what we have to do to win a tough game on the road against McMurry.
All right, Coach, thanks for talking to us today here on the ETB Sportsnet.
Appreciate it.